It's Pocoyo. I wonder what he's doing. He has a whistle, a traffic light, and a crossing. Pocoyo is a traffic policeman. Fantastic! And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A bicycle? A bus. A car. Now, Pocoyo. Well, good night. Oh dear. No one is paying attention to the traffic light or the whistle. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a whistle!
A whistle, right. And that?
A traffic light!
Right. A red light means stop. A green light means go. Uh-oh. Oh dear! Can you tell Pato what that is?
A crossing!
When you cross the street, you must use the crossing. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, sit. That's it. Everyone sit. 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 Fred says, stand up. Stand up. Everyone stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Fred says, lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Let's all lie down. Fred says, that's all. Oh dear, this looks bad. Pato says, please be our traffic policeman, Pocoyo. You need need to pay attention to the traffic light, the crossing, and the whistle. Now you know why you need a traffic policeman. Much better!
If you want to cross the street, you need to use a crossing. And then look at the traffic lights and listen to the whistle of the traffic policeman.
Traffic light! Crossing! Whistle! Bicycle! Bus! Car!
If you want to cross the street, you need to use a crossing. And then look at the traffic lights and listen to the whistle of the traffic policeman.
Formula Pato. Welcome to the Great Race of Pogoyo. And look at the wonderful trophy. Pato looks very sure that he's going to win it. And here are the pilots preparing their cars for the race. Aren't you doing anything, Pato? Oh, I see. You were waiting for a package. I wonder what it is. The Great Champion Engine! Now it's time to prepare your car. Your car is alive! But Pato, do you really think the car understands you? Oh, it does. Now the great race is about to begin. The pilots are revving their engines, ready to compete to see who's the fastest. Pato?
Pato?
Where's Pato? Oh, there he is. Everyone is finally here. On your marks, ready, go! I wouldn't celebrate yet, Pogoyo. Wow! Looks like nothing can stop you now, Pato. Nothing but the ball orchestra. Come on, don't be grumpy, Pato. What's wrong with dancing a little? Oh, oh my. And the race continues. Pato overtakes Pogoyo. He's burning his tires, ladies and gentlemen. What a struggle for the lead. Pato prepares to overtake and... Oh, what's happening? Oh, it's Nina. It seems your car wants to play ball. Isn't that cute? I see you don't think so. Pato is back in the race. He's gaining on Ellie. He's very close, but...
What's this? Oh no! Watch out, Ellie! And Ellie is saved. Thank goodness. Right, Butto? Butto? What are you doing, Butto? Show of camaraderie. What an example of fair play. And what a relaxing beauty treatment. The race is in the final straight. Butto passes Ellie, then Pocoyo. He's going for the finish line. Oh. So close. And Ellie is the winner, followed by Pocoyo. What a race, ladies and ducks!
The trophy!
That's it, the true winner of the race! Butto, do you really think you deserve that trophy? It's for the car. He helped everyone, don't you agree? Maybe you didn't win the race, but you sure won a new friend. That's it. Hooray for a winning friendship. Goodbye. See you next time. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie and Butto. What's going on here?
Race!
Oh, I see. You're having a race. What fun. Okay, everyone. Ready, steady, go! And Ellie is in first place, followed by Pocoyo in second, and in third place is Butto. Wait! Butto is first! Poor Ellie and Pocoyo. Hi, Ellie.
Ellie, search, Ellie.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Fast.
Ellie is searching for fast things.
Fast,
yes, that is fast. Very fast.
More. Slow.
Pocoyo would like to see something slow.
Slow.
This is slow. Very slow.
Thank you, Ellie.
Yes, thank you, Ellie. Well done. Yes, Butto, you're still in first place. Oh no, you're second. Ellie's first. Oh, there goes Pocoyo.
Can you tell me who is in first place?
Ellie! Ellie is first!
Yes, you're right. And who is second?
Paco is second. It's Paco!
Indeed. And who is third?
Pocoyo is first!
Pocoyo, that isn't very nice.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish that drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's a pig!
A pig!
That's right! It's a pig! Well done!
Looks like Pocoyo is still in first place, and here come Ellie and Pato!
Oh no! Something is wrong with their cars! And Pato's! Look! Ellie and Pocoyo are racing on foot! Wonderful! Everyone came in first! What an exciting race!
Ready! Steady! Go!
What have you got there? A bicycle? How wonderful!
Wait!
Huh! Look at those wheels! What is that?
Scooter!
A scooter! And what a lovely scooter it is! Did you see that? Pato wants to go for a ride too. A skateboard? Terrific! Oh, what fun! And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo.
a bus.
Bus!
An aeroplane. Train. Now, Pocoyo.
Train. Bye. Train!
Well, good night. Caterpillar, look out! Can you tell Caterpillar what Ellie is riding?
A bicycle!
A bicycle!
Right, a bicycle! And what is Pocoyo riding?
A scooter!
It's a scooter!
A scooter! Right! And what is Pato riding?
Skateboard!
It's a skateboard!
A skateboard! Right! Caterpillar says she wants to ride too.
Princess! 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 Princess!
And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, walk backwards. Walking backwards is fun. Whoops. Fred says, roll. Come on. Roll on the floor. Fred says, hop. That's it. Hop on one foot. Well done. Fred says, that's all. Aren't you forgetting something, Caterpillar? Exactly. Oh dear, that skateboard is too big. That scooter is too big too. That bicycle is way too big. Oh. Oh, poor Caterpillar. Everything is too big for her. You have an idea? Look! Pato's giving Caterpillar a ride on his skateboard. And Ellie's giving Caterpillar a ride on her bicycle. Now Pocoyo's giving her a ride on his scooter. Wow! Riding with friends looks fun!
If you can ride a bicycle, a scooter or a skateboard, then you can go anywhere. Doesn't matter if it's near, doesn't matter if it's far. You can ride a bicycle, a scooter or a skateboard, then you can go anywhere. Doesn't matter if it's near, doesn't matter if it's far.
wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all round the town. The wipers on the bus go swish, 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 swish. The wipers on the bus go swish, 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 all round the town.
Are you? Ah, just a quiet day by yourself. That sounds very relaxing. Why, look, there's Pato. Ellie, I think Pato wants to go with you. What's that, Pato? You wouldn't mind driving? That's very nice of you. What do you think, Ellie? Pato, Ellie was hoping for a relaxing day today. Ah, yes, much better. More friends, Ellie. One more couldn't hurt, right, Ellie? And off we go, all together. What's the matter, Nina? Oh, of course. Pato, you'd better stop the car. You too, Pocoyo. Yeah.
Oh, great. Just what we needed. Which way to the beach?
Look at that. There.
Ah, very good, Ellie. Maybe he can tell us how to get there. But we're back at the same place again. Oh, no, not again. Begin. Well, Ellie, there's nothing like sharing this marvelous sunset with your friends, is there? Even if it was a little hard to get to the beach. Goodbye, everyone.
Oh, look! There are Pocoyo and Ellie. They're out for a ride.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello, Ellie.
There's nothing like a relaxing ride on a nice day to make you feel wonderful and bring friends together. Oh my! It seems like Ellie and Pocoyo's relaxing little ride together is becoming a race.
And there's Plato.
But where's he going? Aha! There he is, I see. Pato wants Ellie and Pocoyo to have a real race. How exciting! Gather round, everyone. Ellie and Pocoyo are going to have a race to see who's faster. I think Pato wants to get things going. So what are you going to say to get the race started, Pato? Yes, you say ready, steady, and then what comes next, Pato? Oh dear, Pato can't remember what comes next. Can any of you help Pato to get the race started? Say it with me. Ready, steady, go! And they're off! Well done, isn't it thrilling? Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck. Oh, and I think they've woken Sleepy Bird. Oh, and look, it seems as though she wants to join the race as well. Oh, it doesn't look like she can go very fast. It looks as though Ellie is taking the lead. Oh no, what bad luck! Ellie appears to be stuck in the sand. And there goes Pocoyo, leaving poor Ellie in the dust. I mean sand. Wait a moment. Looks like Ellie has an idea. What's she going to do? She's pulling herself out. Pull, Ellie, pull! She did it! And she's off again! Nice going, Pocoyo. You're way ahead. You're working up quite a sweat, aren't you? Oh, my. This is very strange. What are you doing now, Pocoyo?
Ice cream.
You're eating an ice cream in the middle of the race? Well, I must say, you must be feeling pretty confident if you're eating ice cream. Oh, Ellie. Well, you'd better get going if you want to win the race, Pocoyo. And he's off again. Look at that Pocoyo go. Oh, and there's Sleepy Bird. Pocoyo and Ellie are neck and neck again. What a race. Oh, no. What was that? It looks like the car and scooter have fallen apart and so close to the finish. Oh dear, how are Pocoyo and Ellie going to finish the race without a car or scooter? You know, I wonder if there's a way you might still be able to finish the race. Just think, Pocoyo. You have a bit that still works, and Ellie, you have another bit. Is there a way you can make a new vehicle, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo and Ellie work out how they could make something new? Yes, if you put each of your pieces together, you can finish the race together in style. Look at that! Pocoyo and Ellie have made a caruta. Perfect! It appears that you both won the race together. Oh, well, actually, it seems that Sleepy Bird is the winner. Ah, I suppose it just goes to show. It's really not who gets to the finish line first that matters. The fun is all in how you get there. And with whom. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Ellie.
Hi.
I wonder who that is.
Pato.
Oh, my. Pato says that he's going on an aeroplane and that he forgot his suitcase. Pato says that he really, really needs his suitcase.
I bring.
I hope they make it. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. Ah, what's that?
Story.
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was an ant who went to the beach. He took an aeroplane and a ship and a motorbike. But once he got there, he missed his friend.
I am so lonely.
So he called his friend the dinosaur. So the dinosaur took an aeroplane and a ship and a motorbike. And when he got to the beach, he and the ant had a fun time. The end. Running with a suitcase is hard, isn't it? Wonderful idea, Pocoyo.
Bus!
You can take the bus. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's the bus!
The bus!
That's right. It's the bus. Now you'll get to the aeroplane much faster. Wonderful idea, Ellie. You can take a train. Can you tell Pocoyo and Ellie what that is?
The train!
It's the train!
It's the train. Number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 3 sandwiches. Very good.
3 sandwiches.
Oh dear. Well, how about 3 apples instead? 3 apples. Goodness. Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
3 hearts.
That's right. 3. Looks like Pato is still waiting for his suitcase. Ah, there it is! Just in time. Sunglasses? Uh-oh, Ellie's mad. She rode a bus and a train and ran to the aeroplane to bring you sunglasses? Pato says, don't be angry. Look! You're going on the aeroplane too! Traveling is fun, but traveling with friends is even better.
If you travel on a bus, you travel on a train, if you fly on an aeroplane, always take your suitcase. If you travel on a bus, if you travel train, if you fly on an aeroplane, always take your suitcase. Your suitcase.
Tiny Fun Park. Hello, everybody. Are you going someplace? So, you're going to the amusement park. What fun! Oh, my. I guess you'll have to wait for the next bus.
is... Well, don't worry. There's still one more bus today. And here it comes. Oh. And that was the last bus. What a shame. No amusement park today. But maybe you can find something that's just as much fun.
Aha!
What do you have in mind, Nina? What fun! But it looks like Pato isn't feeling so well. Now it's Ellie's turn. Awesome! You've made an obstacle course to play on. Don't worry. You can do it. Pato wants to show you his idea for a new ride. Roberto, I think Pato needs some help. Be careful! You're flying too high! Congratulations, guys! With a little imagination, you've got your own amusement park at home. Bye-bye, everyone.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Hello, Pato.
Oh, what's that?
Scooter, scooter, scooter.
Hmm, whose is that lovely pink scooter?
Ellie's.
And I wonder what it's doing here. Perhaps she's forgotten it. What do you think? Should they take it back to her?
Yes! Take it to Ellie.
Take it to her.
Uh-oh.
Work, Pato. You're quite the expert on the scooter. Looks like Pato is ready to show what an expert can do. Woohoo-wee! You really know how to handle that scooter, Pato. I like your caterpillar scooter, baby bird. Pato thinks you should stick to taking pictures of him, at least until you're bigger.
Oh my, that does look impressive.
Oh dear, I don't think Ellie's going to be happy about this.
But Pato, that's Ellie's scooter. Pato's having too much fun to remember. Oh my goodness. Oh no! Oh, Pato, no! That was Ellie's scooter, remember, Pato?
Ellie! Ellie!
Oh, whatever are you going to do? You really think Ellie will like your, sculpture as much as her scooter? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
Hey!
Ellie's coming!
Pato? Is that you?
Hello, Ellie. Ellie, maybe you shouldn't get on your scooter just this minute. Oh, Ellie! Oh, dear.
You see, Ellie, your scooter is broken.
They'll get it fixed. Don't worry. They tried their best. Really, they did. You shouldn't
hug them.
You mean you're not angry that your scooter's broken?
What's going on?
Oh, I see. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Ellie has there?
A new scooter!
Ellie's got a new scooter!
Yeah, right. And quite a fancy scooter at that. Oh, dear. All that worry for nothing. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for telling the truth! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
But what's that you're doing? Following somebody's trails? I wonder who left those footprints. They're rather small. I think I know. They are exactly the same size as Pocoyo's feet. Can anyone help Pocoyo guess who made those footprints?
Pocoyo!
It's Pocoyo's feet.
They're quite right. Pocoyo, you're following your own footprints. But what's that? Look, there are more footprints. And whoever left them isn't wearing shoes at all. In fact, I think they've got little paws instead of feet. Who left those prints? Do you know, Pocoyo? Well, did you leave those prints, Pocoyo? Can any of you help Pocoyo guess whose prints those are?
A dog!
It's Lula!
Why, you're right! It was Lula! You see, sometimes we leave tracks or prints behind us, like when we walk on sand at the beach. Now, those are very mysterious. Who or what do you suppose left those?
Round.
Yes, they are round.
Big!
You're right. It's big, too. Much bigger than your footprint, Pocoyo. Big, round feet. I wonder who on earth it could be. Pocoyo, do you know who could be leaving these tracks? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who has been making these big, round tracks?
Ellie!
You're right! It's Pocoyo's good friend, Ellie.
Hello, Ellie!
You certainly do have big feet, Ellie. Now here's someone who's leaving some very interesting footprints. Hello, Pato. Going for a swim?
Oh,
But what sort of prints are these?
Big!
Yes, whoever left these prints has great big feet, even bigger than Ellie's. And whoever it is has webbed feet.
Whoever left those footprints, it certainly wasn't a boy, a dog, or an elephant, was it, Pocoyo?
So who could it be?
What's that?
Oh, no, Pocoyo. I don't think it could be a monster. Pocoyo? Pocoyo, if you just take a look... Pocoyo, I know it looks as though the monster is very close by, but really, there's no need to panic. Look, Patter, that's strange, isn't it? The prints are right behind you. Can you see who left those scary-looking footprints, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose feet match these footprints?
Patto!
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 It was Patto all along, in his flippers, going for a swim. Hooray for Pocoyo! You solved the mystery of the great big monster. Good work. Bye-bye. See you soon. Oh, look. Here comes Pocoyo. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Oops. Oh, my. Are you okay, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what's blowing everything about?
The wind!
Yes, it's the wind! Oh, look, here comes Patto. Hello, Patto. Whoops! Oh, no! The wind has taken your hat. Patto, what is it? Patto, please, I'd like to help you, but I can't if you won't tell me what's wrong. What's that, Patto? You think your head looks funny without your hat? But Patto...
Patto! Play!
Patto? Well, I say, that's a dashing bird's nest hat. Will you go and play now? Uh-oh. Patto, why are you hiding from Pocoyo? Oh, you're afraid he'll laugh at your bare head?
Patto!
That's the problem with cloud hats. They do tend to float away.
Pato, are you sure you really want to wear a flower pot as a hat? Heavens! No, that's not really you, is it? Oh, surely not. That's a bit strange. No, that makes you look... This is getting ridiculous. Let's all tell Pato to stop.
Stop, Pato!
Well, I suppose that'll do as a hat. But really, you do look fine without one, Pato.
Oh, no.
Oh, poor Pato. He's really upset.
Pato's afraid you're going to laugh at his head, Pocoyo. You know, Pato, everyone has things they don't like about themselves. Ellie says she thinks her ears are too big. And Baby Bird wishes he weren't such a funny colour. And what about you, Pocoyo? And Pocoyo thinks he's too small. Me? Oh, well, as a matter of fact, I am perfect. No, actually, I think I'm too tall. But friends don't notice these sorts of things. They love you for who you are, not what you look like. What do you think? Do you still like Pato, even though he doesn't have his hat? For Pato and his bare head. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye bye. See you soon.
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo is building things today. There's nothing more fun than building a nice tall tower.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Well, other than knocking it down, that is. It's also a good day for a friend to come over and play.
Ellie!
That's right, Pocoyo. Ellie is coming to play. Oh, I say, you're stamping and trumpeting. You're pretending to be Ellie. Well, it might be a good idea to clean up a bit before she arrives, don't you think? Not so excited about cleaning up, eh? Oh, a broom! Yes! A broom! Isn't that exciting?
Ooh!
Oh, I think Pocoyo really is excited about the broom. Do you know how to use it, Pocoyo? Well, that's not exactly what I was thinking, but it does look like fun. Do you know what Pocoyo is pretending the broom is?
A horse!
It's a horse!
You're right. Pocoyo is pretending the broom is a horse. I see. Cowboy Pocoyo. That's very good.
Yes, that's very good. But it's not...
Oh, now you're playing ice hockey, and the broom is your hockey stick. I always loved ice hockey. Pocoyo shoots! He scores! Pocoyo! Pocoyo! That was just wonderful, Pocoyo, but... Oh, yes! Do any of you know what Pocoyo is pretending the broom is now?
Guitar!
It's a guitar!
That was amazing when you did that thing and then you jumped and swoosh and then all the blocks fell. Just so cool. Well, that's strange. I thought brooms were supposed to make things tidier. That reminds me, wasn't there something we were supposed to be doing? Oh, my. I think I remember now. Someone was coming over to play. Now, who was it? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
Ellie! Ellie's come to play! Ellie!
That's right! Ellie will be here any second. We've got to clean this mess up and fast. I say we've got to clean up before Ellie arrives. Now calm down, Pocoyo. Just think for a minute. Pocoyo, I'm sorry, but this is no time for... Oh, I see. Pocoyo is putting his horse and his hockey stick. And his screaming guitar to work on clearing up. What a brilliant idea. The blocks are getting tidied up in no time. Hooray for Pocoyo! Cleaning up does fly by when you're having fun, eh, Pocoyo? And just in time for Ellie's visit. It certainly has been a good day for Pocoyo. Finding out that clearing up can be fun with a little imagination. It looks like there's more fun yet to be had. Bye! See you soon! Ah, there's Pocoyo. Pocoyo, over here. Pocoyo? Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
So, Pocoyo, what do you think you'd like to do today? Oh, look at that. Do you know what that is, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a telephone!
Phone!
So, Pocoyo, I suppose you're trying to work out what it does. Well, that curious object is called a telephone. And sometimes it makes a noise.
It says... well, yes, exactly. That's what it says. Ring, ring. And when it says ring, ring, it means... oh, Pocoyo has an idea. Where are you going, Pocoyo? What are you doing now, Pocoyo? Oh, I see, Pocoyo. You thought the phone might like another ring-ring to talk to. What a fun idea. But I'm afraid a phone isn't for talking to other things that ring. Oh dear, I think Pocoyo is upset. Don't give up yet, Pocoyo. Who could you ask for help?
Battle!
There's Pato now, and it looks like he's just about to dig into a snack. I think Pocoyo would like to show you something, Pato. I think Pato's hungry, and it's very hard for a hungry duck to be patient. You see, it does ring, and now it appears to be talking. Well, why don't you try listening to what it's saying? Yes, you. Why not? Now, Pocoyo, do you know what to say into the phone after it rings? You say, hello.
Hello. Hello.
Exactly. Well done. That's what a phone is for. You can talk to friends, even if they're quite far away. But I wonder who could be calling you. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who it is?
It's Ellie.
Ellie.
You figured it out. Hooray for Pocoyo. Ellie's having a party. That's why she was calling. Isn't the telephone a wonderful way of communicating with your friends? Oh, there you all are. Well, it looks like you're having a splendid time. Thanks to Ellie. And the phone, of course. Bye. See you soon. Thank you.
Pocoyo and Lula are going to the beach today. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Lula, too.
Hi.
That's right. A day at the beach. They have a picnic lunch and a beach umbrella and... Pocoyo, where are you going? That's not the way to the beach. Ah, good idea, Pocoyo. A ball. A round, orange, little ball. What a good thing to take with us.
Round?
Yes, round, like a circle. Very good, Pocoyo. Well, I'm sure Lula will love to play fetch with it in the sand. Now, we'd better get... Pocoyo, the beach is, not that way either. Oh, dear. There you are. Now, where is that ball? Do you see it, Pocoyo? Which one is it? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball?
The round one.
It's round.
Round.
That's right, Pocoyo. Your ball is round. Now we can go to the beach. Our friend Pato seems to be having fun. Very nice, Pato. But, oh, look out! Phew, that was close, wasn't it, Pato? Uh-oh, here comes Lula. Oh, poor Pato, and after he worked so hard. Pato, I think Pocoyo's ball is somewhere in here. Can you help?
Round.
Yes, Pato's right. Everything here seems to be round. But wasn't there something else about your ball, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo which one is his ball? Oh, Lula sees it too. Oh, no, not again. Sorry about that, Pato. Juggling! How clever! Look out! Oh, dear. Hello, Ellie.
Ellie!
Oh, this looks a bit more difficult, doesn't it? Perhaps you should tell Ellie what your ball looks like.
Rounds. Orange.
No, that's not it. What else did we say about the ball? It's round, it's orange, and... Can any of you help Pocoyo work out which one it is?
It's little!
Little!
Good thinking. So, now that you've got your ball, do you think we can finally go to the beach? The beach! Oh, I see. Well, I suppose we got here after all. Hooray for Pocoyo! All in all, it's a lovely day for Pocoyo. And for me too, for that matter.
Bye-bye.
Bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hi, Ellie. And hello, Pato. Oh, I see. You're going to race. What fun. Oops. Okay. Everybody ready? When I count three, let's all shout go, shall we? Ready? One, two, three. Go! And the winner is... Pocoyo! Pato's ready to go on to the jumping contest. Well done, Pocoyo! Excellent jump, Pato. We might be looking at a winner. What's this? Bad luck, Pato. Ellie wins. Oh dear, Pato is a very bad loser. What's this? Looks like some very fancy running shoes. Why not try them on, Pato? Nice. Oh dear. Oh no, Pato! Those shoes seem to have a mind of their own. Looks like you've got them under control, Pato. Wow! Pato wants to know if you two would like to have a little race. All right then, everyone, join in again. Ready, steady, go! Pato wins! Yes, Pato, we know you're the winner. I think we can already declare the winner,
Pato wins!
I don't think they want to race against you anymore, Pato. Ellie has noticed your super shoes. Looks like those shoes don't want to be taken off. What's this? Good work, baby bird and caterpillar. You did it. I suppose you learned something here today, Pato. It's just not worth cheating.
Play!
Excellent idea, Pocoyo. What do you think? Should Pato keep his shoes?
No!
Don't keep them!
Well done! Hooray for Pato! Hooray for fair play! Bye-bye! See you soon!